Assalamu alaikum guys, hi to every one of you. Welcome again to my YouTube channel. Here Mohammad Imran for you all. So last time we were discussing about how to use if statement in C sharp using Visual Basic. So this is just prerequisite lecture related to if condition. So today we are going to learn how to use if and else if statement. If you have more than one condition, then you can easily use if else if condition. The syntax is still staying related to if condition, but you just have to add this one, else if. If you have one condition, then you can easily use if condition and else. If you want to use more than one conditions, then this is a very easy concept to use. So this one is else if statement. As if condition, if it will not run, then the cursor will come here and check this condition, else if statement. If you want more than one, so these are more than two, so then if it will be wrong, then it will come to else if. And it just depend upon your conditions that how many else if conditions you want in your program. Okay, then if all the conditions will be wrong, then automatically else condition will be run according to the compiler. So compiler first check the condition, then it will run. So let's have a practical how to use else if condition by using Visual Basic. So I have already shared all the basic concepts related to C sharp, that these are namespaces and these are class and these are main function, and we are just going to write a program related to else if condition, if else if. So now everyone is ready, just follow the steps for your learning. So beginners, are you ready? Okay, let's start. So first of all, we have take a number, okay, and which is integer type, and this is a declaration. I have not given any value, so this is no initialization. So int number declared by me. So first of all, console, as you all know that console.writeline is used for input. So double quotes, enter student marks to check grade. Okay, so double quotes and brackets and semicolon, and it will show you the same thing as you are writing in the double quotes. Okay, so again, now we have to take a number from the user. So as we already discussed that the syntax of input from the user is number one, which we have declared, is equal to convert dot to 32, and then console read line brackets, and this bracket will close, and it will, first of all, it will read the strings from here, and then it will convert into the integer type as we already discussed. So I am going to put the condition if number is greater than or equal to 80, then it must run console dot for output and wow, congratulations, your grade scoring is A and the marks are, and double quotes, and now I am using this concatenation operator and number, which the user will be given to through by cursor. So semicolon. So this is the first condition. So now we are just putting else if, and if we have more than one condition, then we can use else if num is less than or equal to 79, because here is the A grade, so we must have to less than 79, we have to limit to the sample. So and operator, num is greater than or equal to 70. Okay, and then we just copy these There is no need to write again and again. Here we have to use blocks. Okay, so grade is B, congregation report is B, but still need block it. Okay, so just copy this line and save your time. And now this is 70, so we have to limit to 69 and greater than 60. So your grade scoring, here we can use C. Okay, but still in prime marks are these. Okay, so again else if, and here 59 and here 50. Okay, so these marks are too much low. So I hope so everyone is intelligent here, those who are watching my channel, and your grade scoring is still need too much improvement. Okay, so be intelligent, don't be like that to get C grade. And at the last we will use else condition, and if you don't have any, then just don't fail. Console, write line, and oh no, you are failed, and try again. Okay, and the marks are, double quotes, concatenation operator, and number. So here is bracket close. So now I have to use console dot, and don't forget to write to mention these lines, because without it your screen will not be hold for the time and it will disappear and appear. Okay, so I have, first of all let's check either this program is working or not. Click on start, debug it. Here enter student marks to check grade scoring. So first of all I just declared a number of data type integer and console.write, and it will show you the same thing as I just mentioned in double quotes, and then it will ask you to enter number as this cursor is blinking. So I am just putting here number 81. And first of all, if number is greater than or equal to 80, of course if number, as I put 81, then of course 81 is greater than or equal to 80, so it will show you the wow, congratulations, your grade scoring is A and marks are A. Congratulations, grade scoring is A and marks are 81. So if you will put 80, so if you will put 80, then of course 80 is equal to 80, so it will show you again. Okay, and press Ctrl F5 for the shortcut. And if you will press 78, and congratulations, your grade scoring B, but still need improvement, and marks are 78 as it is falling in this condition. Okay, and now again check Ctrl F5. Now we will check that 61 62. So this condition is falling here. First of all it will go here, it didn't satisfy the condition, then it comes here, it didn't. So when it come here, the compiler check the condition and it is true, so grade scoring is C, but still need improvement and marks are 62. Okay, and let's check the last one. So if you got 53 marks, then your grade scoring is C but still need too much improvement. So if you don't have good marks, then what will be the console application will show you according to the condition. So here, and if you got just 20 marks, then what will be? Or no, you're fail and try again, your marks are 20 because it didn't satisfy any of the condition among these. Okay, so this is the tutorial for if else if. So it is just prerequisite to if else condition, and I hope so this is understandable to everyone. And if you don't want to put these algorithm, put these program to your laptop, so just copy and paste. If you want to copy and paste, then just comment or ask from me there, just send this code. And don't forget to subscribe my channel. I just need your subscription, and just share with your close one. And thank you for watching, and just be touch with my YouTube channel, as I always here to update my channel with new video. Thank you so much. Thank you for watching. Just stay blessed. Allah Hafiz.